Hello. Welcome once again. In this video, we will see how to creating the animation blueprint. You will require an animation blueprint that will determine what character animations to play based on the current actions by the player. Additionally, you will need to set up a state machine to create a walk and crouch state, then set up the transitions between each of them. So let's begin. In the content browser, click Add, Import and then Animation, and then Animation Blueprint, and when prompted to pick a skeleton, choose the UE4 mannequin skeleton. Then name your animation blueprint as Player Character AB. Double-click Player Character AB to open the animation blueprint. In the My Blueprint tab, navigate to the Variables category and select the adjacent plus sign to create two Boolean variables and name it as is crouched and is jumping. Click the Event Graph tab, then drag off from the Return Value pin of the TryGet Pawn Owner node. Then from the drop-down menu, search for and select Cast to BP Player Character. Drag off from the As BP Player Character Return pin of the Cast to BP Player Character node. Then search for and select Get as Crouched. Navigate to the My Blueprint tab, then from the Variables category, drag and drop the As Crouched variable onto the return pin of the Get As Crouched node. Drag off from the Cast to BP Player Character's Output Execution pin, and connect it to the Input Execution pin of the Set As Crouched node. Drag off from the As BP Player Character Return pin of the Cast to BP Player Character node, then from the All Actions drop-down menu, search for and select Get Press Jump. From the My Blueprint tab, navigate to the Variables category, then drag and drop the As Jumping variable onto the return pin of the Get Pressed Jump node. Drag off from the Set As Crouched node output execution pin, and connect it to the input execution pin of the Set As Jumping node. Compile and save your player character AB animation blueprint. Now from the Variables category select the adjacent plus sign to create two float variables named Speed and Direction. Drag off from the As BP Player Character Return pin of the Cast to BP Player Character node. Then click to enable the Context Sensitive box and search for and select Get Velocity. Drag off from the Get Velocity node's Return Value pin, and from the Actions drop-down menu, search for and select Vector Length. In the My Blueprint tab, drag and drop the Speed variable onto the Vector Return Value pin of the Vector Length node. Next, connect the Execution Output pin of the Set As Jumping node to the Execution Input pin of the Set Speed node. Drag off from the As BP Player Character Return pin of the Cast to BP Player Character node, then search for and select Get Actor Rotation. Drag off from the Get Actor Rotation node's Rotator Return Value pin, and from the drop-down Actions menu, search for and select Calculate Direction. Next, drag off from the Vector Return Value pin of the Get Velocity node, and plug it into the Velocity Input pin from the Calculate Direction node. From the My Blueprint tab, click and drag the direction variable, and drop it onto the Float Return Value pin of the Calculate Direction node. Next, connect the Execution Output pin from the Set Speed node to the Execution Input pin of the Set Direction node. Drag off from the Event Blueprint Update Animation node's Execution Output pin, and connect it to the Cast to BP Player Character node. Now compile and save your player character AB animation blueprint. Your completed animation event graph will look like this. Hope from this video, you will start to move into building in more advanced mechanics, in an easy to follow step-by-step approach, which will allow you to play around and build your own content, to eventually build your own game. Thanks a lot, see you in the next video.